Okay, children. So today we are going to discuss about problems based on the four topics already we have discussed yesterday. No, so means in the previous class. So same here the problems let us discuss the. So yesterday the four topics. First one is graphical representation. Then second one is relationship between coefficients and system of equations. The third one is substitution method. Then fourth one is elimination method. So we have discussed about these four topics in the previous class. So here now problems. So we'll see why exercise one. See children, right? So in this exercise 4.1, so one problem I will explain, right? So the first one is, by comparing the ratios a1 by a2, first bit a1 by a2 comma b1 by b2 comma c1 by c2, comparing these ratios, state whether the lines represented by the following pairs of linear equations intersect at a point, are parallel, or coincident. So here three are there, no? Intersect, okay, then parallel and coincident. So out of these three, so which one satisfied for the given linear equations? By comparing these ratios, we have to say the given linear equations are intersecting or parallel or coincident. So as we know already, I told you table, no? Right, based on that, see, then I'm going to explain the first one, A in this, right? So solution and given equations, right? What are the given equations? 5x minus 4y plus 8 is equal to 0, 7x plus 6y minus 9 is equal to 0. So these are the given equations. This is equation number 1, equation number 2. So first we have to find out these ratios. First a1 by a2, 5 by 7, comma b1 by b2. That is equal to minus 4 by 6, 2 2s are 2 3s are minus 2 by 3. Next, C1 by C2. Then here, 8 by minus 9, nothing but minus 8 by 9. So because the minus is in the denominator, so always we should write in the numerator. So after finding all ratios A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. See here, if any ratio equal, no. So here, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. So when the first two ratios are getting not equal, then we no need to see the third one. So now, what is the condition here? A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2 we are getting. Then what, children, here? What is the first condition? So A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. If not equal to these two, then what condition satisfy in these three? So first one, if A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2, then the lines are intersecting lines. So therefore, the given lines आर इंटरसेक्टिंग. Lines. Okay, children, this is. So, the remaining two, just you have to find out ratios. Based on this, you have to express then what is out of these three, which one is satisfied. That's enough. Okay, children, here we are not getting the given lines are intersecting. If A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2, then what is? The lines are parallel. Then A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equals to C1 by C2. If three are equal, the lines are coincident. Okay, children? Then remaining two, you do as homework. Okay? Now let us discuss second one. Okay, children? Right, second bit. So here, second bit. So first one I will explain. Okay, the remaining all graphs only, then you can do, no problem, don't worry. Right, check whether the following equations are same, consistent, consistent or inconsistent. Solve them graphically. So here we have to use graph. So consistent, two types we know, the intersecting lines and coincident lines. Consistent, if intersecting, consistent and independent. If coincident, consistent and dependent. So inconsistent is nothing but parallel. So first we have to check the given lines are consistent or inconsistent, then after, then solve them graphically. Okay, children, see here, that first one, second bit A, given equations, right, what is 3x plus 2y is equals to 5 and 2x minus 3y is equals to 7. So these two equations are given. So first constant value we have to transpose to the left side, no? Right. So here, right, 3x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to 0. Equation number 1, 2x minus 3y minus 7 is equal to 0. Equation number 2. First we should find out A1 by A2, 3 by 2. Then B1 by B2, 2 by minus 3. So B is 2, B1 is 2, B3, B2 is minus 3. One values we have to take from the first equation, A1, B1, C1. Then 2, A2, B2, C2 from second equation. So next, here nothing but we can write minus 2 by 3, no? Yes. Next, C1 by C2, minus 5 by minus 7, minus minus cancel, 5 by 7. See, children, here any equal? No. Therefore, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Therefore, the given lines are consistent. Okay? Right. So, because if they are consistent and intersecting lines, okay, children, intersecting lines. So after this Now what we have to do? These two lines we have to solve by using graphs. See children, so first to represent graphs, so here first we have to find out two tables. Okay, for the first equation one table, second equation one table. So already as we discussed in the previous class. See children, the tables. Right, first. So here first we have to find out y value, right? 2y is equal to these two, you transpose here, it will become plus 5, this minus 3x. Then y is equal to 5 minus 3x by 2. This is x values, this is y value, 5 minus 3x by 2. This is x comma y value. Okay children, so first I am taking 0, right, y value. If you substitute here 0, 3 into 0, 0, 5 by 2, nothing but 2.5. 2.5 we can keep on the graph. So 0 comma 2.5. Next, 1 I am taking. So y is equals to, if you substitute here 1, 3, 1s are 3, 5 minus 3, 2. So 2 by 2, that is equal to, again 1. So 1 comma 1, 2 points enough. Okay children, then next, this. Right, if you transpose here, 2x minus 7 is equal to 3y. Then y is equal to 2x minus 7 by 3. Then this is another table. X values, y is equal to 2x minus 7 by 3. Then x comma y. Okay children, so here x value, right, if you take 0, so here minus 7 by 3. So with 3, 7, we cannot get cancel, right? Then take 1. So what we will get? 2 1s are 2. 5 by 3 also not possible. Then take 2. Okay? I'm taking 2. Y is equal to 2. 2s are 4. 4 minus 7. Minus 3 by 3 means minus 1. So 2 comma minus 1. Okay? Next, we'll see. Then if you'll take minus 2, minus 1. Y is equal to 2 into minus 1, minus 2. Minus 2, minus 7, minus 9 by 3. Nothing but minus 3. 3, 3 is a 9, no? So minus 1 comma minus 3. These points represent on the graph. Y axis. Then this is x1, x axis. Then 0, 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, like. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7. Okay children, so next, first graph, means first equation, 0 comma 2.5, 0 here plus 2.5, means in between 2 and 3, here we will get a first point. Next, 1 comma 1, 1 and this is 1 comma 1, right? So next, with the scale, then draw a line. This is first equation what? 3x plus 2y is equals to 5. Then second one, 2 comma minus 1, 2 comma minus 1 here. Minus 1 comma minus 3, somewhere you will get. Then you join like, okay? We With the scale you will get perfect, right? Like straight line will get. So this is what? Equation 2x minus 3y is equal to 7. So these two lines are intersecting here. Then take a line here and draw one more line here. Then where this line is intersecting on y-axis, that is y value. Where this line is intersecting on x-axis, that is x value. So your solution, you write x comma y, nothing but x values you should write, children. Why I am taking x comma y? Perfect value I don't know, just I am taking a, for example, no, so that's why. But in the graph you will get perfect answer, so that's why you write x plus x value, y plus y value. Then scale, you know, right? On the x axis 1 unit is equals to 1 centimeter, and on the y axis same 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. Okay, children? So this is graph. This is very important for 4 marks. So compulsory question in the examination, public examination. Okay, children? So next, remaining second bit, all the problems are our homework. You practice, take a graph book, I told you, no? Graph book, this total second bit problems you have to do in the graph book. Okay, children? So very carefully, then next we will discuss in the next class.